Hi, and welcome to my YouTube channel, The Narcissistic Guide. This is a channel dedicated to narcissism, narcissistic abuse, narcissistic behavior. And there's a lot of information on the internet and on YouTube about narcissism, a lot of information. But this channel today, we're going to talk about the female covert narcissist. The female covert narcissist can be recognized by seven very important traits they have. First of all, they are very obsessed with their beauty. They don't take no for an answer. They flirt with anyone and everyone. Female narcissists find it very hard to apologize. Lack of empathy for others. They don't negotiate. They manipulate. And they are highly competitive. So, female covert narcissists are very concerned about their looks, their body size, to their outfits, you know, fitness obsessed, not all the time, but most of the times. Their makeup, they always need to look good, so they always need to look well, if not better than others, at all times. You see them having a very, how do you say, they can be very irresponsible with money, so they can put you into debt as well. They love to shop, they love to spend money. It doesn't matter how much money, if they have the money or not, but they will ensure that they can spend money. They don't have any goals in life, they don't have any ambitions, no, you know, like, they're just like lazy. Covert narcissists are very, very lazy. Yeah. They have a very inflated sense of self. Yeah. And they always need to be right all the time. They always need to be right. They're never wrong. They're perfect. They're very, very perfect. They think that they're perfect. They think that you're always wrong. It's not a, they never make mistakes. They don't want to be held accountable for their mistakes. They don't want to be held accountable for their responsibilities because they think they are perfect. And if you reject them, it is considered a direct attack on their self-esteem. So that is what they absolutely hate, if you can reject them. Female narcissist, covert narcissist, she can flirt with anyone. Yeah, she even flirts with people they don't like. So if you have friends, or she becomes part of your, you know, if she gets to know your friends, she will even flirt with your friends. All right, a narcissist, doesn't matter who comes into her path. If she can flirt with someone, she will flirt with someone. And she will always also accuse you of flirting with others. And she is very jealous if you have other female friends in your circle. Because they think that they flirt with you while they're actually not flirting with you. But, you know, they're making a problem of something, you know, not to make a problem of in the first place. A female narcissist finds it very hard to apologize as well. So they believe they are better than others. Yeah, narcissists have problems with accepting their faults and apologizing. They will shift blame on others and avoid taking responsibility for their mistakes. They never take responsibility for their mistakes. It doesn't matter how much proof you have of the mistake they've made. They will never admit it. And if they have to admit something, they will always blame it to something or someone. So it will never be something like, all right, yeah, I made a mistake. No. A female covert narcissist will never, ever want to be held accountable for their mistakes and their responsibilities. Yeah, also, you know, like normal responsibilities in life, like you have to pay the rent, okay? You have to pay your monthly bills. You have to pay, you know, for your health care insurance or whatever. They just don't care about responsibilities, because they have no ambition, they have no goals in life. They don't want to settle. It's not about settling in life. It's not about getting somewhere in life. It's not about becoming wiser in life. They don't care about, you know, settling down, getting married, you know, investing in the future. That is absolutely something a narcissist won't do. They want things to happen quick. It needs to happen quick. Rush, 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 rush. Yeah, they never take time for anything. And female covert narcissists, like every narcissist, they lack empathy, but the covert female narcissist is even worse than that. They lack empathy for others. Like they're self-centered. They struggle with opinions of others. So even if you have a very healthy opinion or you have a very constructive feedback or criticism that you want to give to a narcissist, they don't like it. They hate it. They hate every form of opinion or criticism you might have, even if it's healthy, even if it's logical. Like if a female narcissist has a problem with something that seems so small, and you find a logical solution for that problem, a narcissist will never accept that kind of feedback from you because they know better. They know, they're right. It's not, like they have it under control. They know what to do. And if a problem becomes big, if a problem becomes very, very big, and you're like, oh shit, I have to help this narcissist because she is in deep trouble. And you're doing all you can to help this narcissist to get out of that situation, to try to help them, to lift them up, to help them to get out of a problem. And it's a big problem. Like, let's say, just to give an example, maybe they are not able to pay the rent or whatever, and they are on the edge of being, evicted from their home. And that doesn't just happen, overnight. It happened over a period of time that they didn't pay the rent or whatever. And they spend the money on shopping or beauty products, just being very irresponsible with money. And you're trying to help the narcissist. Then, at that the time that you're helping that narcissist in the heat of the moment, in the moment that they're in deep trouble, you're helping the narcissist. You're providing the money they need to prevent that they'll be evicted from their house or their apartment. Okay, you help them. They will always downplay it in the future. They will never, ever, ever say, oh, wow, you remember that time that you've helped me when I was in deep shit and I almost got evicted from my apartment and you helped me? No, they will not. They will say, it was not a big deal. It was not such a big deal. It was just a small, I could have solved it myself anyway. That is what what a covert narcissist does as well. They're not thankful. They're not thankful for you helping them. They don't know what thankful is. They don't know what it is to appreciate your help, appreciate the way you've helped them at the time when they were so panicking, like they were really panicking, and you were like, okay, gosh, I have to help this person right now because that's how you are, right? Because you're like a good person, you have feelings, you have empathy, you want to help someone who is in trouble because that's normal, that's the way you are. And a narcissist, they don't care. They really don't care. They don't, even if you give them $1 million, I swear, they don't care. Like they will forget. They will also always remind you of the stuff they've given you. A female covert narcissist will remember what they've given you 8 years ago. For example, if you have a female narcissist friend who gave you a bottle of perfume 8 years ago, she will still remember that, and she will mention it. If she can bring it up, she will mention it. She will tell you, you remember that time that I gave you a bottle of perfume? Oh yeah, that was 8 years ago. Gosh. And then think, sit back, reflect a little bit, and think about the stuff that you've done for that narcissist, how much you have given them. Okay, if you want to try to shut them up, you just say, do you remember the moments that I've helped you when you needed help the most? Those are the moments that count, right? I mean, like, we all give each other a bottle of perfume sometimes, or a gift or whatever, eh? And I swear, with a narcissist, if you want to count it, and maybe you're not the type of person like me, I'm not the type of person, if I give something to someone, I will never mention it again because it means that it's coming from my heart and I give it to someone. But if you reflect back on the stuff that you've given a narcissist, right, probably you will win that competition, right? And female covert narcissist will compete even if there is no need to compete. They will always compete. You're not even competing, but the narcissist is competing. She's competing with everyone who is on her path, her friends, her best friends, her husbands, her whatever. They will compete with everyone. That is what a narcissist does. And it's very, very, very annoying, very sickening too. Now, a female narcissist also, they never negotiate, they manipulate, okay? A female narcissist, because they're so fragile, their egos, a narcissistic woman, they do not believe in negotiation. However, they are master manipulators. It's like they can manipulate unsuspecting people easily, to get things their way. That is what a female narcissist can. They can manipulate. They are master manipulators. It's like an act. You know what I mean? Like a female covert narcissist is a great actress. They can act so well. It's like they should just win an Oscar for their acting skills, because they are very, very, very good at it. And they are very competitive as well. So a female narcissist has an alpha attitude that makes them very competitive, right? And envious and jealous. They are always envious and jealous. Just like I said before, if you have a narcissistic girlfriend or a narcissistic friend, you will see how she is always envious of the people around her and jealous. And she thinks that everyone is also envious and jealous of her. She will maybe, like, you know, like, not make it really obvious, but she will give subtle hints like, oh, your friend is flirting with me, or why are you flirting with her? She will tell you, like, she's accusing you now of flirting with one of your female friends. Well, it's just a friend. Maybe you know her from your childhood or whatever, and you're maybe acting like brothers and sister, you know, like, it's possible, right? You can have a relationship with a female friend, you know, as a brother and sister, because you know that person from your childhood or whatever, right? But a female narcissist, when she comes into your life, she will create chaos. She will be destructive, right? She will be destructive. I swear she will be destructive. She will create chaos in a harmonious atmosphere. She will create chaos. I swear you will see this as a pattern anywhere, everywhere. And she feels that she's the victim. That's the most frustrating part. A female covert narcissist will always play the victim role. She will always try to expose the truth, her truth, right? Not the truth, but her truth, right? She will always try to, you know, expose the people who have hurt her, all right? She will always try to do that. They're paranoid. They're really paranoid. They're really thinking that everybody is jealous of them. They're always on edge. They're always so sensitive about, you know, like, it's just crazy. It's really crazy, right? It's like, they may act very nice to people who pose a threat, all right? But they will deceive and manipulate their way to superiority. So, oh my gosh, over others. Even when there's no need to do it. But they will always try to do it. And they will likely always succeed to do it. The signs that you can look for when you want to recognize a female covert narcissist is that they're always trying to make you jealous, right? So if you're in a relationship with a female narcissist, she will always try to make you jealous. She will always try to make you be like, you have to be thankful that she is your girlfriend or a friend. So if you're in a romantic relationship, for example, or not even in a romantic relationship, she will try to make you feel that you should be thankful that I'm with you, because a lot of people want me because I'm so special, you know. They're feeling so entitled as well, like, and they feel like they're special children of God. A female covert narcissist is really thinking that they are, like, you know, I'm a special kind of child of God, and especially if you have a religious covert female narcissist, my gosh, that is the worst, because they will play the scripture game on you and everyone around them, and you will notice. She will always say, like, oh, that person hurted me so much, God will expose the truth and God will punish them in front of my eyes. If you have a religious covert narcissist around you, look out for that, because that is really, that is just really crazy. I mean, like, come on. God is not gonna God doesn't punish everyone who hurt the narcissist, but that is what a narcissist thinks, because they're delusional. They're really delusional. They really think that the world evolves around them. It's all about them. Okay, so if someone hurts her, they need to be punished. But when the female narcissist hurts someone else, no one needs to be punished because the narcissist thinks they're perfect, right? So, okay, that's crazy, right? It's absolutely, it's crazy because they have like unreasonable standards or expectations as well. Okay, a female covert narcissist feels that they deserve special treatment. Okay, so for example, if there are rules, let's say they have to go to work and they're late for work. They don't feel that they're wrong, that they're late for work, because the rules don't apply to them. That's just a very small example of how they are very unreasonable in their standards, because they expect to be treated special. A female covert narcissist will always bend or think that the rules don't apply to them. But they do apply to you. They do apply to any other person around them, but not to the narcissist herself. And I already told you they are very materialistic. A female covert narcissist is very materialistic. Yeah. And always has money troubles. Very irresponsible with money. I said it before, they're very irresponsible with money. They're very irresponsible with spendings. They are very irresponsible in keeping up paying, normal, logically, monthly, mandatory payments for their rent or whatever, gas, light, and everything else. But they don't care because they just love to spend money, because they need to spend all this money for their obsession of beauty and for their clothing and for their perfume and everything they need, foundation, whatever. It's always, and they have a very expensive taste. Tell you, it's not cheap. There's not cheap stuff that they're buying, like, a $5 foundation that they're buying. They can buy foundations for $60, $70, you know what I mean? Like perfume, $100. It doesn't matter to them. It doesn't matter if they're going to get into debt, you're going to get into debt. It doesn't matter to them. Yeah, all right. So what a female narcissist also love is they are addicted to drama. And if there's no drama, they will create drama. Okay, look in a harmonious circle of friends you have, and this female narcissist enters this group of friends, okay, you will see most of those people after a few weeks. It takes a few weeks, right, because it's very hard to spot a hidden narcissist, a covert narcissist. You will see that she will make this group become dysfunctional, okay, and people start to become suspicious of everyone else, you know what I mean, because she will give a little grain of some truth into a conversation of this group of friends, and then you will sort of kind of believe it a little bit. But before the narcissist came into the picture, it was never a problem, but she's making a problem of it. All right, let's just say you have a friend who is drinking a beer, for example. So it in your group of friends, drinking a bottle of beer but has to drive. Okay, you can drive after drinking a bottle of beer, for example, but she will make a problem of it. She will make an issue of it. She will make an issue, like, look how bad, just to ensure that the focus is not going to be on the narcissist. She likes the attention, she will love the attention she's getting, but she will try to ensure that the attention will of, like, oh, that person is wrong because he's drinking beer and he has to drive. So she can make the person look bad, right? So that is her intention. That is creating drama, right? So that is what narcissists love. A narcissist love to have drama. They are addicted to drama, gossiping, absolutely love it. They gaslight everyone. They love to do smear campaigns. That is what a covert narcissist is good. They're masters in all of this destruction within a harmonious relationship or group of friends or whatever. They're masters in it. And a covert narcissist, a female covert narcissist, what they also do is, when you are having a relationship with a romantic relationship with a female narcissist, is that during the love bombing phase, they often try to isolate you. And they do that with a purpose. So during the love bombing phase, you know, like you're getting everything. This the love bombing phase, you have to look at it as an investment. The covert narcissist is investing in the relationship because it has to be, and it has to happen quick. Rush, 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 rush. No, slow, slow, no. That doesn't exist with a covert narcissist. It has to happen very quick, very quickly. You'll be rushed into a relationship. Yeah, she will say, "Oh, you're my soulmate. We have a soulmate connection. It's love at first sight. I want to be with you forever." Future faking, all that stuff. That is what the narcissist, the female narcissist, will do during the love bombing phase. So during the love bombing phase, they will try to isolate you, right? And why do they do that? Like, for example, they will have you move to a different city or different country even. They create chaos between you and your trusted friends or your confidants. They disparage your family to make visits difficult or almost impossible. And the motive is very simple. The motive is to isolate you from anyone who would advocate for you or call out abusive behavior from the narcissist. So that is what they often do when you are the new supply. When you become the new supply of a narcissist, they often do this. They will isolate you, and they will ensure that the attention is all on the narcissist. And what the female narcissist also does often is that she denies all the lies, everything she said or did that is toxic. So she will absolutely never want to be held accountable. She will make you confused. You will never see yourself having a satisfied conversation with a narcissist. It will never go from A to B. A conversation with a narcissist will always leave you confused. Normally, with a healthy person, say, you will, if you have a discussion or you have an argument, the conversation will go from A to B and it will be resolved. You know what I mean? But with the covert narcissist, it will never be resolved. You will never have satisfaction. It will leave you confused. You will leave a conversation very confused. And you will even hear, if you have female friends and they get to know your girlfriend who is a narcissist, they will kind of in a subtle way will say that she is crazy, you know, but they cannot see or understand yet that they're dealing with a narcissist because they're very hard to detect. I swear, hidden covert narcissists are very hard to detect. And if you have a female covert narcissist, she will always criticize everything about you. Everything and never seems to honor your perspective on things or even your goals or your ambitions in life because it's not about your goals and it's not about your ambitions, it's about the narcissist. A narcissist doesn't care if you have goals in mind or you have ambitions in life, and this person will absolutely ensure that you will give her all the attention. Everything is about her all day, every day. Okay, and if you have success in life, she will claim that success. She will make you feel that the success happened because of her, not because of you. And another thing that a female covert narcissist does is she uses sex as leverage. That is one of the very most, you know, like during the love bombing phase, you cannot have enough of it. You will have a lot of sex, but during the relationship, you will see that she will use it. She will use sex as leverage. That is what a covert narcissist do. And she is doing it primarily to keep control and power. Control and power is all that she's after. She wants to control you. It's all about the narcissist. She needs to be praised like a goddess or whatever because that's the attention they think they deserve. Be they entitled to that, all right? Because a female narcissist feels entitled, right? When you have a relationship with a female narcissist, it is only giving. You give and she will take. She will only take. She will never give. She will not be considerate about your feelings. She has absolutely no feel, you know, she has a very lack of empathy. No empathy actually at all. There's no empathy within her. I don't believe that they have empathy. They are not capable to be, you know, empathetic. They project that they can be because they mimic the emotions. They learn to, you know, like it's life th for them, going through life for them is like an acting school, right? They evolve, they do evolve. A female nar people say narcissists don't change. Yes, they do change. They change in their games, they evolve in their games, they become smarter, they become more intelligent in playing the game, you know, and that is what they do. They are like Oh, I swear, Oscar-winning actresses, they should win an Oscar for their acting performances, but also for their directing skills, because they can, it's like creating a movie, and they decide where this movie is heading to. They decide what the outcome is of the movie, all right? And you will be left emotionally distracted. You will be emotionally so drained, not even only emotionally, but also physically. You will lose your concept of a healthy life, You will lose your harmony, and you will lose your peace. So that is what I wanted to talk about today, about the signs of a female covert narcissist, one of the most sneakiest narcissists you can ever meet in your life. So that's it for today. Now, if you have any comments or you have any questions, please leave them in the comment box on the channel, and subscribe to my channel, The Narcissist Guide. Next time I will be talking about another subject. I'm not sure what yet, but it will probably be about the religious covert narcissist, because that's a very interesting subject as well. Because that is, you if you already dealt with a covert female narcissist, that's worse, that's bad already. But dealing with a religious one, religious covert female narcissist, wow, amazing. That is just beyond crazy. All right, so thank you for listening, and see you next time. Thank you.